Hi everyone, it's Michael. So I have another very nice problem for you all. This one was posted by Parmenides. He's a poster on the Art of Problem Solving forum, and he always has some great problems, so thank you very much for posting this. He posted it twice. The first time he said it was from the Ukraine team selection test in 2013, and the second time he said it was from South Africa in 2019. So maybe the second competition borrowed it from the first. But either way, it's a very nice problem. So if you want to try to solve it, feel free to pause the video. All right, so now I'm going to go over it. So we have an isosceles triangle ABC, where BC is the base. AD is a diameter. And T is any point on the smaller arc BD. Then we have that... the line DP meets AB at M and AC at N. And we have that BP meets AD at Q and CP meets AD at R. And we want to show that the midpoint of segment MN lies on the circumcircle of PQR. So there's two ways to get started with these kind of problems. One way is you could label the midpoint of segment MN. So let's say it was E. And then you could try to show that PREQ is cyclic. So that's one way to do it, but I did it sort of the other way. So I said, first let the circumcircle of PRQ cut MN at a point, and I call it E. And then we want to show that E is the midpoint of MN. So I just found this to be sort of an easier way to tackle it. Okay. So, ultimately, we want to show that ME is equal to NE, but I'm going to start first by doing a little bit of angle chasing. And so this angle chase is going to lead me to conclude that AB is parallel to QE. So here I'll show you that angle chase. So we have angle EQR is equal to angle EPR, okay, because PREQ is cyclic. EPR is DPC, and then DPC has to equal DAC because APDC is cyclic. DAC is equal to DAB because ABC is isosceles, so since AD is a diameter, it also has to be an angle bisector of that triangle. Okay. So if EQR is equal to DAB, then obviously we have to have AB is parallel to QE because they're alternate interior angles. So this gives us a couple ratios. Ultimately, we want to show that ME is equal to NE to solve the problem, but this gives us DE over DQ is DM over AD. But it turns out we can combine, ultimately we want to have ME in an equation. And it turns out we can combine those two ratios. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So DE over DQ is DM over DA. But whenever you have two fractions like this, you can add the numerators and add the denominators, and it gives you still the same fraction. So DE plus DM over DQ plus DA. And the whole reason I did this is because I don't want DE alone or DM alone in the final result. I want the sum ME. So when you add the two, DE plus DM is ME, and DQ plus DA is AQ. Okay, so we have DE over DQ is ME over AQ. So we did that with the point Q. We did all this stuff with the point Q, showing QE is parallel to AB. But we can do the same exact argument with point R. So I'm going to sort of spell that out here. So in the exact same way we did for point Q, we now have for point R, we have angle ERQ is equal to angle EPQ. And EPQ is equal to angle, should be DPQ right here, not DPA. So DPQ. But DPQ is equal to DAB. That's because ABPD is cyclic, if you see that. So BPQ is sort of the exterior of angle BPD, and the opposite of that is angle DAB. So we have to have BPQ is DAB, and like I said before, DAB has to be DAC, since triangle ABC is isosceles and AD is the diameter. So that has to be true by symmetry. So if ERQ is equal to DAC, so this angle ERQ is equal to DAC, well, those are corresponding angles, so AC has to be parallel to RE. And so if AC is parallel to RE, then we have to have DE over DR is NE over AR. So very similar argument to what I did before. I'm not sort of adding the fractions like I did before, just because it's kind of clear to see this way. Because it just so happens because E lies between D and N, but it's really the same idea. Okay, so ultimately I want to show ME is equal to NE. So I want to see if I can combine these two equations. So they both have DE, so that probably cancels. But then I have a couple things left, DQ, AQ, DR, and AR. So how do I combine those four? And ultimately it turns out that we want to show that they're in harmonic conjugation. That would ultimately result in showing ME is equal to NE. How do we get that? So we have AQ, AR, DQ, and DR. How do we get those four points all lie on a line? How do I get them in ratios? Well, if you look closely, first you'll notice that since AD is a diameter, angle APD has to be 90 degrees. And then also, so APD is 90 degrees, and then it also turns out that PD is an angle bisector of RPQ. And that's due to all the qualities up here, because we said ERQ, so we have angle EPR here, so EPR is equal to both DAC and DAB. And then at the same time, EPQ is also equal to both DAC and DAB. So they have to be equal to each other. So EPQ is equal to EPR, and they're both half of angle A. And so PD has to, or EP has to be an angle bisector of RPQ. And so that's an angle bisector, and angle APD is a right angle. So whenever you have this kind of a configuration, you have four points on a line, and the first and the third are at a right angle with another point, and then PD is like the angle bisector of RPQ, it always turns out that those four points have to be in harmonic conjugation. So their cross ratio has to be one. So this is the theorem that I just sort of know. It's not too hard to prove, but it's very well known if you work with cross ratios and projective geometry a lot. So if you haven't seen it before, I'd recommend trying to prove it. But that gives us exactly the ratios that we need to solve the problem. This is equal to, so what ratio does D divide the segment QR into? That would be DQ over DR. And for point A, it would be AQ over AR, but we want the ratio of those two ratios. So we have to have DQ over DR times AR over AQ has to be equal to 1. And now we have all the information we need. When you combine all these equations, so if you cut out sort of the middle two equalities and you take DE over DQ is ME over AQ, DE over DR is NE over AR, and this final one, when you combine them all, you end up getting exactly what we want, which is ME equals NE, and that solves the problem, because that means that E, which is where the circumcircle meets MN, is actually the midpoint of MN. So this used a little projective geometry here. Maybe there's a way around it. So if you have any other ways of trying to solve this problem, feel free to post it in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And as always, if you'd like to see more, subscribe to my channel. Thanks, everyone.